video is edited and in good shape, there are a few last steps you might want to consider to help you improve your video, but also to make it more accessible to those who will watch it. In terms of making your video better, it's always good to have someone else, not involved with the editing, watch the video and provide feedback. There are best practices for giving feedback, some which you can see in the Getting Better Feedback on Video lesson of the TechSmith Academy, which is linked below. Here are just a couple suggestions. You should keep the group providing feedback small, or you may get too much and conflicting feedback, which you may not be able to act on. As you send your video out for review, you should ask and state exactly what you're looking for from your reviewers. This includes anything you don't want. If you don't want feedback on the color scheme of the logo, you may want to mention this. The more specific instructions you can give your reviewers, the more likely you are to get better feedback. If you're working with reviewers who have never reviewed video before, it can be helpful to ask them to provide feedback associated with the time on the timeline that they have feedback for. For instance, if there's feedback to give at 1 minute 15 seconds, they should note the time before the comment. There are products like TechSmith Video Review that can make the review process easier. It provides a central location for the video and comments. Reviewers leaving comments stop the playhead at the point they want to leave feedback and add that feedback. And then it's marked for you and other reviewers to easily find. Other reviewers can then add their thoughts to the comments in a threaded conversation or click the like button to indicate agreement. The key though, however you go about getting it, is to get feedback early and before you make your video public. Another step you might want to take before publishing is to add captions to your video. Captions will make sure that viewers who are deaf or hard of hearing will still have access to the content of your video. In some cases, it may be a legal requirement to provide captions. Captions can also be helpful to those who work in a noisy environment or one where they can't or aren't able to listen to the audio. Even though they can't hear your audio, they will still effectively be able to follow along with the captions. Other useful add-ons to your video include setting up a table of contents. Think of a table of contents as an index of key points during your video. They are especially helpful for longer videos. They can help your viewers easily navigate to different sections of the video without having to guess where you started talking about a new topic. In this example, you'll notice that the viewer can jump between the items listed in the table of contents. Some programs, like Camtasia, will allow you to add a table of contents in the editor. But for the most part, the table of contents will only be visible if you're using the TechSmith Smart Player. However, depending on where you're hosting your video, you may be able to add the table of contents after the fact on your video hosting service. Once you've made any changes based on your reviewer's feedback and added captions or a table of contents, it's time to make sure that you have everything saved. Next up, we'll take a look at rendering and publishing your video.